All right. So this discussion, I guess I'm gonna broach Mars, since it's opening. Hasn't it had its opening recently? You know, its grand premiere. Ta-da! There's water. It always has been, and now we found it. So there's water flowing, or puddled, or whatever. I didn't actually read every detail, but there's water existing. So now the... Okay. All of this throughput, everybody's like, what's there more, you know? Does it offer mankind anything? You know, do we need it? You know, so there's a rush to NASA already in people's minds. I have to get to NASA and even have that water. Maybe that water offers me something extra, some existence in life, longevity or something. You know, so you already have those people. Then you have the other ones that are already like trying to... But God put us on this planet here, Earth, and there wasn't supposed to be water over there, and so now they have to change their story. So it has become an interesting weirdo. All of a sudden, you know, science has found water on Mars. So what I wanted to talk about actually was more about the elements that exist there versus the elements that exist here on the planet Earth. The elemental differences. Now, very possibly they're exact same elements existing on Mars that exist on planet Earth. It's a different combination. When I'm looking into the combinations of the elements here on Earth, we're looking at all of the minerals and that coordination that is the chemical makeup that is in all of our brains, in the brains of a bird, in the brains of a human, in the brains of a dog, the brains of a cat, you know, or a lion, you know. So you can see that you know how we have this waxing and waning of our emotions. The earthlings, the earth animals, we have a waxing and waning. You know, when things don't go right, you can tell. Animals mope, animals complain, animals cringe, they hide. They have the same exact responses as humans. They have the same responses, you know. So they're just in animal form, you know. It's what they're capable of. Now, I believe all of these responses are happening in the brain, just like you have the release of your happiness, your release of your sadness. I believe all of this is happening in the brain, and that's the chemicals that are coming here from the planet. Okay, so now, if you have that going on, that makes us all very, very alike. Now, if you're looking, we're going over to Mars, and let's say there was a life form there. Now, that particular life form is going to be created from the makeup of only those elements from that soil grouping. So let's say we have 300 amino acids that create our brain power and how we are like and our hates and our compassions and our discompassions. Now, over there on Mars, we may not have the 300 aminos. We may have maybe accessible to the life form. The life form itself may only have 35. And so, thusly, you may end up with severe, as many people have already predicted Mars to be, as quite a kind of a dark stereotype of a cold man, a discompassionate male. It's a very interesting stereotype that's been created all throughout the years. So in that tone, in the same tone, I'm thinking there. So there was like 35 amino acid grouping for the life form. Now, so it's not going to maybe have that veracity display of happy or sad, or you know, it's not going to have, you know, the love ability, the hate ability to the same extremes. It's going to be a different, isn't it? Maybe extremely cold. very calculated, a very cold, calculated life being. So it's very interesting. It's a very interesting topic, because you're really only now looking at water and those particular elements of a bland planet. And so there, that's really all I have to say. I know it was quite of a jubilation at first, but then yet I'm like, I don't know. You know, it's not really a jubilation, is it? You know, maybe it is, you know, something extraordinary that can be one that doesn't want to tamper within our bodies. You know, maybe we don't want to mix with it. You know, maybe it is bad for us, you know, bad for the life forms here on the planet, you know, bad for our brain power, you know, to be good people, or good dogs, or good cats, or whatever. You know, maybe it's just bad for us. So anyway, yeah, could be a weakener, a severe weakener. Like we got hit with a meteorite that just like takes us over and just turns us all into marching robots, you know what I mean? That type of a deal. You know, such a heavy component element that it just switches our brain away from being nice, switches our brain away from knowing happiness, or even wanting it. Yeah. So anyway, so that was my fear spell on the Mars, hello, yeah. So I don't know if clouds can come over here from Mars, I doubt it. I don't think they can drift over and drop, but it's kind of a funny idea, huh?